Before you begin, always use Google Chrome as your internet browser. You can use Safari if using a Mac. Using other internet browsers will result in not having full functionality within Ektron CMS. Go to the Ektron CMS self-directed training webpage and find the heading Documents for Training. Click on the CMS text Word document. It will download to the bottom of your window. Click on the drop-down arrow and select Open. You will use this document later. You can minimize it if you would like. Click on the Best Bare Books hyperlink. Another tab or window will open with this PDF file. In the lower right corner, select the Save icon. Select where you want to save it, such as the desktop. Save as, for training only, enter your name at the beginning of the Save As field. Click Save. User experience. A website is often the first impression a visitor has of an organization, and our university is no different. We want the visitors to our site to be able to locate the information they are looking for quickly and efficiently. While there are many different departments, programs, and organizations with their own unique focus, we are all Northern Arizona University, and we want to present our website with a unified look and feel. As you go through training, we tell you our best practices, and we have templates, known as smart forms, in place to give our site visitors a cohesive experience. Resources. We have several resources to help you as you learn Ektron CMS. If you go to nau.edu, you can search our site by putting in the keywords CMS training. The first result that displays is our homepage. On the Ektron CMS webpage, there is an online manual. The online manual on the left navigation, also known as a menu, contains step-by-step guidelines to the most popular features used in Ektron CMS. Go to the media link to find out how to add images, galleries, and videos. When you add images, be sure to check the image size index. This will have correct picture sizing. Pictures and videos should be added thoughtfully to complement the text on your page. Make sure that pictures and videos are of good quality and resolution to reflect the quality of our university. Go to the Advanced tab to find advanced procedures, such as how to add menus and site-wide sidebars. For immediate assistance, give us a call at 39CMS or 39267. Navigate to the online manual now, as you might want to reference it later. Log in. Open a new tab or window in your Google Chrome browser. Navigate to nau.edu/CMSWork by typing it into your internet browser. Click on Log In. You may be prompted to enter your NAU user ID and password. When you come to the screen, select Work Area. At the top right of your page, click on the Content tab. Structure and organization. Just like at your computer, our web pages are saved in folders. We will send you the folder path to your folder once you complete training and we grant you permissions. Just like dining, your folder will contain a Forms folder. This is where you save all your PDF documents, Word documents, Excel documents, and PowerPoint files. The Media folder is where you save pictures, galleries, and videos. For consistency across websites, always follow these guidelines. For today's training, you will be working in the Training folder. Click on the plus sign next to the Training folder. Then scroll down to Ektron CMS. Click on the name of the folder, Ektron CMS, and it will display its contents on the right-hand side. what your finished page will look like. In order to receive permissions to your website, you must present proficiency within Ektron CMS. Follow the steps outlined in this training. When you are done, your webpage will look like this. Page names or titles. Next, you will learn how to add a new page to your website. Before I show you the steps on how to add a new page, let's discuss how to name the titles of your pages. For information on this, navigate to our online manual and select Add Pages. Page names or titles are important since they appear in the page's URL and breadcrumb trail. Both the URL and breadcrumb trail help site visitors easily identify where they are, and therefore it is important to follow a couple guidelines. If you are creating your site from scratch in Ektron CMS, name the homepage to your site Welcome. The reason is that it maintains consistency across all sites. When titling a page, do not use the name of your folder in the title of your page. The reason is the name of your folder will show up in the URL and breadcrumb trail next to the page name. In this example, Art Museum is the name of the folder and Mission Statement is the name of the page. The only exception is that the contact page will include the name of your folder. When titling a page, use no more than 2 to 3 words. The reason is more words or even long words end up making a long URL, and the page title may not even fit in the area of the breadcrumb trail. So try this instead. Pick a few keywords. Use relevant words that will help improve your search results. When titling a page, use a space between your words. The reason is the CMS will replace your space with a dash in the URL of your page. For example, a title of sample space page will appear as nau.edu/sample-page in the URL. When titling a page, do not use special characters. The reason is the CMS will end up replacing special characters such as a percent sign, dollar sign, asterisk with a dash, so it becomes a cleaner URL. When titling a page, capitalize your words, unless they are an article. The reason is this will make your URL and breadcrumb trail easier to read. Add a new page. Now that you've learned how to title a page, let's add a new page. If you haven't yet, double check the top right corner to make sure that you're in the content tab. On the left navigation, scroll down and click the plus sign next to training. And then click on the name of the folder, Ektron CMS. The Ektron CMS folder is where you'll be creating your page for training. You will now create a new page. In the middle of the page, select the star icon for new, then scroll down to Smart Form. For training, we will click on Page Standard. Most of the pages on your site will use this template. Page Open is used as a landing page to direct visitors to other places on the site. One example of a page open is the NAU Experience page. This points the visitors in 4 different directions. Another example of a template you could use is a faculty staff page template. Here is an example of what it looks like. Contact eden-help@nau.edu or call us at 39267 if you have any questions on the Smart Form template to use. Name your page, the page title. Title the page by typing in the title box. Remember, your page name appears in the URL and breadcrumb trail. Keep the title short and concise. Do not include the name of the folder. See the web page, Page Names, for all the guidelines on the page name or title. Name your training page with your first name and last initial. For example, Amy space E. Create a heading for the page by typing in the page heading box. The page heading will be visible as a H2 heading and will be the main heading on your page. For training, use the heading All About Bears. If there is content on your page that needs to be changed periodically, click on the Schedule tab. Otherwise, you can skip this step. Ideally, pages should be checked and updated at least once per year. Let's clean up this page. Click back on the Content tab. Look closely at the headings to make sure you're removing the correct ones. Next to Write Sidebar Content, click on the blue notepad icon. Select Remove. Next to the Next Steps, click on the blue notepad icon. Select Remove. Red dotted lines on your page signifies required information, so we will need to add text to the Layout Editor page content. Copy and paste text. Go to the CMS text Word document that you opened earlier. Highlight the entire text in this document. Using Ctrl-C, copy the entire text. Go back to your Ektron CMS page and place your cursor inside the Layout Editor field. Note, do not directly paste the text. This will cause your text window to disappear. Should this happen when you are editing a page, do not publish the page. Instead, click the red Cancel button. You will then need to log back into Ektron CMS. To paste your text, right-click. A menu will appear with a couple options. Paste from Word. This option will copy formatting such as bullets, italics, and tables. Paste plain text. This option will strip out all formatting and leave only text. Use this format if someone has submitted inaccurately formatted text. Since this text is formatted with bullets, select Paste from Word. In the window that pops up, paste your text using Ctrl-V. To see a preview, click the Preview button. When ready, click the OK button. Note, anytime you have a list of three or more items, consider making a bulleted list, like this list of books. Edit your text. Use the blue toolbar at the top of your page to format text. Formatting can include bold or italics. The second drop-down in the menu offers four different text styles. To change the style of your text, highlight the text and select the style you want to use from the drop-down box in the toolbar. Normal text is used for the plain text you find on your page. Heading 3 is used for first-level headings. Heading 4 is used for smaller headings within H3 headings. And Heading 5 is the normal size bolded text used within H4 headings. Use the headings in the order they are presented. H3 for first level text, H4 to subdivide a H3, and H5 to subdivide an H4. Following this guideline keeps the look of our site consistent. It also helps visitors that use screen readers to easily navigate our site from one department or program to another. A couple guidelines to follow with headings. Use sentence case for headings. Only the first letter of the first word should be capitalized. Do not hyperlink to headings. On your training page, change the headings Books and Stories and the heading Lectures to be H3 headings. Update Bear of North America series to be an H4 heading. How to edit metadata. When you create a new page, you will want to edit the metadata. Metadata is information or keywords that enable users to search the university site for a specific page. To edit metadata for the page, select the tab labeled Metadata. To add keywords for a page, scroll down to the Tag section. Select Add Tag. A text box will open. Enter in the keywords for your page. Note, when inputting keywords, it is important to remember to enter singular words. For example, enter student and separately enter resources, but do not enter student resources at the same time. When naming your tags, leave out punctuation and capitalization. If they are left in, users will only find the page in the search results if they also input the exact punctuation and capitalization that you used. For training, add the following tags: bear. Then click Save. Add the tag bears. Click Save. Add the tag lecture. Click Save. Click Add Tag, Add Lectures, and click Save. Publish page. Publishing a page saves your content, checks in your page for others to make changes to, and sends it to the live site. Your edits sync to the public site at 15 minutes past the next hour. Once you have finished adding or editing content on a page, click the Publish icon in the gray toolbar. After you publish, you will be brought to the main content page.